in this small viewing box. This is the most venomous spider in all of Africa. And there you can see it, and I know this isn't the most amazing way to view it. I will clean the box out sort of, well, next time I use it, I'm going to release him back into his sort of web, or her into her web. But we can also look at her under the microscope. So let's do that now. I'll just turn around there. I mean, this isn't ideal, but of course I can't really put it on my hand because that will result in, a small visit, as I was saying, to Fergus, to the Nelspruit Hospital fairly soon. And I don't really want to go there. Nelspruit's not a place you want to be on a Sunday. Any day, really. Okay, let's have a... I'm just going to wrap this in black paper so that we can work out the exposure properly. Yeah. There we go. I mean, look, it's not the best picture of this thing in the world. There we go. So that's, look at that. There's the hourglass shape. You can see it in glorious detail there. I'm just going to try and turn the light down slightly. There we go. And I'll go back to the spider now. There we are. Sorry. It's just a little difficult doing it like this. There we are. You can see she's very much alive. Glorious detail there of her wonderful red hourglass. Oh, she's left. She's absconded. I keep getting a fright when she moves because I keep thinking to myself she must be about to escape, but she hasn't escaped. So what we're going to do is take her back outside and we're going to release her. She's getting a little bit upset in here. And the one thing we don't want is Africa's most venomous spider upset, I don't think. I would rather she was very happy. So what we're going to do now is, at great expense or great personal risk, Fergus, she's in. Phew. Onto her web, and we'll just close her and give her some shade and cool. Thank you, madam. Please stay there for at least another week. Taylor has managed to re-find her most favourite animals